okay? Hope you're doing well, and if you're new, welcome to this channel. So today we have a Zara and H&M unboxing for you guys. All of these things are like Christmas. I'm so excited for Christmas, guys. I love Christmas personally. So these items are very much for this season, December time, winter time. So hopefully you guys like them as well. We've got shoes, jumpers, so many different things for you guys to have a look at. So yeah, anything else you want to add, mommy? Okay.
I think we're trying to do both shops this time around. So it's not just Zara or just H&M, it's a mixture. Because we're trying to do like a festive lookbook or holiday lookbook. Yeah, so look out for it as well.
Yeah. So without further ado, let's jump straight into the video. First box we have here, these ones. I already saw actually what mommy had ordered, so I'm excited to see. Where do we have in store? Okay. So first and foremost, wait, what's this one? This is the new one. Okay. So obviously when you think of Christmas, it's all about the gifts, the gift, you know, all that stuff. So mommy saw these shoes online. They're not actually our style usually. It comes in this duster bag. But mommy picked them up anyway, again for the season. But I love how they came. They're in a blue, as you can see, but they're these glittery.
They are actually glittering because of the sun.
The sun, isn't it?
Yeah.
Gemmed blue shoes, sling bags. They look amazing, guys. I love how they look. The blue color, first of all, it just pops and looks really good on the skin. And then you've got the gems going across it. And I said they did it really well, that it doesn't look tacky. That's why I stay away from glitz and all of that stuff, because it can look cheap. But they've done it so well. Zara have done really well with these. You've got the heels sort of a little bit asymmetrical, still quite slim. And then they've got jewels on the sling back as well.
Can I say something about the heel?
Yes.
Usually when you buy high heels, if you look carefully, there are three positions that they can pull high heels. If you want a very comfortable high heel, look for one that the heel is in the middle
of your heel.
Of your heel. Because sometimes you put it to the back.
The end, yeah.
And sometimes they angle it into the middle. But the best one is this type of heel. So if you struggle with heels and you're trying to, you know, learn how to walk in heels, I recommend heels like that's it right in the middle, and it gives you the best support or maximum support.
Yeah, I agree.
And sorry, Nisha.
Yeah, that's fine.
I was gonna say that as you were saying that it's not tacky. I'm not one to pick up, like you said,
100%.
At all, let alone blue glitter shoes. It's like, what are we doing? But for some reason, I thought, okay, let's try it because it's Christmas, let's try it. And then we got it. We brought it home, and me and Nisha, our jaw just dropped. It's like,
it's
what?
Too nice.
And I think they were trying to do the Christian Louis Vuitton duplicate, because they do a lot of the diamondy, the studs, the you know. And sometimes when I look at it, even though my money can afford this, I think that aesthetically, I don't also, you know,
fit
see. But this is glitter, but muted glitter, classic glitter, you know,
them. Yeah. And it does have padding on the inside, which helps with comfort. And we've got these in a size 6. Now they retail for $59.99.
I think 55 or 59?
59.
59, okay.
Yeah. So it really depends. We are really battling in our heads whether or not it's something that we want to keep. Obviously, if you went for Christian Louis Vuitton, they would be considering like expensive. So this is...
For a wardrobe classic, because I was saying to Nisha that...
It's timeless.
I might be able to wear this a few years down the line and then hand it over completely to her. And she was like, oh, I'll still be able to rock it. I don't know.
Yeah,
by the grace of God, some years down the line, I'll be able to rock it. But I'm saying that if you think about how long you can have it in your wardrobe, then it makes sense. It makes. I don't know about the quality though, because it's not leather.
Right.
So I don't know how durable it's going to
be.
Yeah.
Your saving grace is that obviously it's a very one-time wear.
Exactly.
So that's what could save it. But this shoe just looks... I really, really like it, guys.
So we're trying to haul it now so that if you're interested or you're looking for something unique on the high street for Christmas, I'll recommend
Christmas
this.
Christmas evening dinner, like, imagine. Next box we have is this one. And they had the same shoe coming in the duster bag, but they had it in the gold. Now this one as well, I mean, the color is just spot on. I think people who try to do glitter go for like a yellow gold, which that is what makes it look cheap completely. This sort of antique gold with like almost an olive hue to it makes it look classic and classy and elegant and high end really. I love how this gold looks.
I think the camera is not...
it's not picking it up. You guys need to head over to their website or go in store to have a look, because this looks amazing.
If you have a Christmas party, you don't want to spend a lot of money.
Just get a good pair of shoes and have like a black
dress. They are comfortable. Oh, usually 100%. Shoes like this are not comfortable, but this is very comfortable.
Same thing,
but different colors. And the good news is that they have it in a black leather, another colorway.
So depending on what you... obviously for festive, I say go for one of the colors because I think it will do it justice.
A lot of people are safe with black, but for once I went with blue, so you can also choose.
Exactly.
I'm not one to pick up blue shoes.
Guys, I really, really like these. Yeah. I really, really do. So yeah, do you think they're worth it? Should they get it?
I think they're worth it. I think they're worth it. Because the same shoes, you'll probably pick it up in one of these premium brands.
Yeah.
Russell and Bromley or somewhere.
Yeah.
And you'll pay 200 and something for it. Yeah, so.
Really digging them.
I think they're worth it.
So yes, that was the shoes from Zara. Was there anything else from Zara that you picked up?
No. Because we are trying to collate pieces for, like I said, our Christmas holiday festive lookbook. So, outfit ideas. So
those were what we picked up from Zara. Now moving on to H&M. So we picked up some festive accessories as well from ASOS and M&S.
Yep.
So we thought we'd add those. And from ASOS, we have this little bag. It's actually Paul Costello bag, and the gold is almost like a white gold, so it doesn't have that yellow, that strong yellow hue that a gold, typical gold bag would have. But you have the top handle, so you can hold it like this, and then a cross body, so you can cross it across your body. But yeah, we just thought that this would be a very good festive piece, nice shimmer, and it's real leather, so it's definitely a good buy. How much did you get this one for?
How much was it originally? Look at the tag, please. Can you show us the tag?
Oh, the price isn't on here.
It's not? I think it was 120 and it came down to either 32 or 27, one of those. And I actually picked it up because of, if you know the Prada silver bag that has the top handle.
Yeah, I haven't seen it.
Oh, we'll put it. That was my inspiration, and obviously Prada is going in excess of what I think it was. That one, we'll look at the price, but in thousands, isn't it?
Yeah.
So I thought this was a bargain.
Yeah, and it feels so solid as well. It gives you that sort of small bag vibe, but big enough to still put things in.
Yeah.
So for any Christmas Eves for the mums, this really looks good, but does the job as well. So
I'll try and link if it's still available.
That was this bag, and then we've got a silver bag from M&S. Obviously M&S do have other brands and other companies on their site, and White Stuff is where this bag is originally from. It's just a nice simple crossbody, again has the space for what you need, but the look is festive with the silver shimmer. This is also genuine leather, isn't it?
Yeah, all of them are leather.
And it has this sort of magnetic flap in the front for more storage space, and then the zip up top. But I think it's also very useful for the moms. This was £45 originally. I don't know how much you picked up.
I think it was £19 eventually.
So yes.
But this one, I always see Trini London wearing silver bags. Mm-hmm. I mean, for years, she's worn silver bags. And I used to think it's ridiculous. Mm-hmm. But the more I've seen her use it,
the more
I've become more...
And that's where a lot of fashion things are. It's like you need to see it being done and you understand. Okay. Yeah. If you see it off the bat, you're like, whoa, but...
Trini London, she likes some shimmer, like anything that is glittery or any, you know.
Yeah, it'd be like shimmer on the lid, even her makeup.
But
this one,
Nisha, you can show it. I've had this for years. I think this one is from Nine West.
Oh, Nine
from
West.
From Nine West. It's another designer.
Yeah.
I said Nine West, no. Nine by Savannah. Yeah.
So this crossbody, which I prefer actually to comparison to this one, is a nice...
The other one is more casual.
Yes.
And this one is more dressier.
Exactly. So this one, for, again, evening wear.
But this one, Nisha, the reason why I'm showing this is that I've had the silver bag for years.
Yeah.
Because I've seen Trini do it. But I've never used it. But now it's almost like, oh.
We found you, spirit.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it's a very hard and structured bag. Mm. Is it leather?
Yeah, it's leather.
It's leather, yeah. So, and they've sort of pieced it together by piercing with the studs, which I think is a nice addition. It's like a gunmetal grey. And same sort of thing, like it has space for usage, but you know that it's strong and it's sturdy as well. It has the silver crossbody, so you can hold it as a clutch or you can crossbody over. But out of the two silvers, I think this one is...
It came in two colorways.
So. Oh, okay. So same one, but
unfortunately they are not available. I bought it from Debenhams, by Savannah.
Yeah, I'm sure you could find something that looks alike now. But I guess you guys have a good idea of what you can use for Christmas season. This is a nice burgundy, deep, you know, and
like a berry,
wine.
Yeah.
And it has this really cool leather strap that has a lot of sequins and studding to make it look.
Edgy or Christmassy or...
And if you have a really nice oversized jumper, jeans, throw it across your body. It just looks really, really cool.
If you're the type you're looking for just a little bit of glitter,
then you that's your touch.
Do the whole shebang, then
these two.
And last but not the least,
for a bear collection. This one is vintage, right?
Yeah.
So
I bought it on eBay.
Yeah. A really nice shoulder bag. Obviously, you guys know the shoulder bag drill. But you can have some Christmas editions with the gold. This one is more of the yellow gold I was talking about.
Mm-hmm.
And I like it because, again, there's no shimmer or glitter with the yellow gold. So it makes it look very high-end.
And if you're not using, if you're not wearing anything, what do you call it?
Mm-hmm.
Anything glittery on Christmas or during Christmas, and you just want a pop of shimmer. Mm-hmm. Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, this is the pop.
Yeah.
Just nice, simple sheen. It's soft leather as well, so if you put things in, you can create more space.
Mm.
But I think it's really nice. I like the thin handle as well, actually. I think it looks quite high-end. So yeah, those are kind of like all the bags we wanted to show you.
I think that one too is leather, Nisha, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
Let me see what brand it is.
So obviously during the season, while we're doing styling...
Oh, it's House of Fraser.
You will be able to...
It's actually House of Fraser.
You will see a lot of these bags as we are styling. So yeah. There you have it. Now...
On to Christmas dresses.
To the unboxing. We have... H&M, sorry, I forgot. And so we've got a lot of dresses in here for Christmas as well. That hopefully you guys will see some that you like. First one. Is this one. Now this one I see purple. I see purple. Okay, so we have like almost a crushed velvet dress. Ooh, crushed velvet number. I like these sort of shorter dresses for Christmas, actually, as well.
I don't like it Christmas so much because I thought they were going to be ship dresses, but they look like bodycons.
Oh, so they're going to fit quite tightly. Yeah, I just like the short dress vibe with the heels. I think it looks cute for Christmas dinners, parties, or whatever. But like when we said this one, I think the shift dresses are what makes it.
If it was a ship dress, high neck, long sleeve.
They're perfect.
Yeah,
but it looks like it's gonna be fitted.
The bodycon is not my, you know.
Yeah, again, with the shimmer and stuff, it cheapens it. That's the thing. Mm-hmm. So, yeah. We got this in a small, and like I said, it's almost like a crushed velvet purple dress. We've got a bit of a high neck going on here, and then it's long sleeved. A mini dress which goes down, yeah, straight really, and at the back you've got this opening, so you have the hook and eye to close and then the open back, but yeah, with a pair of heels this could look really cute. Like mommy said, it would be best if it fits shift rather than bodycon.
I mean, I'm thinking of what I can throw on it, like a, I mean, I'm hoping that you can try it on and we can show it on camera, because if it's too body hugging and everything,
then showing, we may not be able,
we'll style it the way we think it's best, appropriate. Yeah. So I'll probably throw on something, I don't know, a white blazer, something that will just take away the
from the tightness
of the whole
dress. For me, it's just a below the knee, so not too short actually, so you don't have to feel
Anisha risky. Thinking of it, you can actually wear it with a high-waisted jean.
Oh, like as a top?
As a top.
Yeah,
definitely. You can't.
I was gonna say, yeah,
high-waisted jean. Yeah. So we'll try that as well.
And yeah, you guys can have a look. But yeah, I really like the concept of this dress. We'll see what it is like on. But yeah, it was a good concept. Even the ribbed is really, it's almost like a zebra style ribbing. The ribbing isn't like,
but it looks like it's going to be very stretchy, isn't it? What size is this?
Small. So yeah, let's see how this one pans out. How much did you get this one for?
I can't lie, I can't remember any of them.
They were all on sale, isn't it?
One morning I just got up and I say, you know what, let me try and get some festive stuff. Yeah,
pieces.
I think this was the one I was actually looking forward to.
This one. So this, again, really cute, really pretty, is a black velvet dress which has just a few sparkles of glitter, silver glitter going through it. And it's like baby doll style. So again, short dress, but it's not figure hugging, so it looks really nice.
I think if it fits you, this would be the one that I would advise you to keep.
Yeah. So it's just a round neck dress, and then it's got a little bit of a flouncy sleeve, just a tad, with the cuffs, and you've got those beaded buttons right there. It's just really cute and pretty, to be honest. You've got a tier in the bottom, and then at the back.
It's like a two-tier thing.
Yeah. And then you've got the tie back.
And I also want to style it back to front, just to see
what it looks like.
In the front too can work.
Yeah, we've got this in a size extra small, actually. This looks big for extra small.
Yeah, because the thing is, that was the only size available. So I picked it regardless because of the cut. If it was like a straight cut, I wouldn't have. Because
it would have been too tight.
But because it's tiered, you normally have more room in it. Yeah.
With the heels, give it a little bit of a twirl.
I'm just scared that it might be a little bit short on you, or the boobie area will be a bit...
We'll see.
Yeah.
But yeah, this one's looking pretty promising. I like this one. So yes, that was the next dress here. With me out is this silver number. I want to see what this one looks like because I liked the look of it. It's a spaghetti strap, sort of a ruched.
It's only Christmas that will make me buy something.
Oh yeah, this mommy. Oh yeah, never. This one gives, you know, huge mama vibes. But if styled right, can actually look very good.
I just see you with the blazer thrown on your shoulder, really.
It's an endorsement.
That's how I see.
So the silver again, and with the black, makes the silver a bit more muted. So it looks a bit like gunner.
It's almost like a grey dress.
Grey, yeah.
Yeah.
With the shimmer. And then you've got the ruching on the side, just for a bit more pizzazz, I guess. But yeah, typically, I think they expect this to be bodycon, but depending on what size you get, things it can sit differently.
And I guess if you're skinny,
you don't have boobs. You don't have anything. Yeah, it could, you know.
It could work. Because when you look at some of the white models, because there's no chest, there's no bum. Yeah, it just slips on their body nicely, you see. But when a black person, well, I'm black, so nobody should come for me. When a black person wears it, it's almost like you are trying to show everything.
Yeah.
And that's what makes it a bit obscene.
So, yeah, it's you and your body type, I guess, if you wanted to look a certain way. I like the fact that it's square neck as well. And we got it in size medium. It says it retails for $12.99, so not too bad. And in terms of length, again, just below the knee, but depending on obviously.
No, I don't think so. I think because of the ruching, what you realize is that it will come above the knee, yeah. Even though it looks long. Like,
yeah, it will be on my knee, no? No?
I don't know.
We'll okay, see let's try see. But yes, you guys will see in the channel video. But this one.
What size was that, Nisha?
Medium.
Medium.
I think there is another dress in here, if I'm not mistaken. Yes. So this is the black version of the purple.
Purple one, isn't it?
Ooh, that's nice. So, exact same one, but in black. So, depending on which one you prefer, you could do this with like a colored shoe or like. Yeah, so this is the black. We got this black one in a small.
I don't know. I see it with black, white boots.
White boots, yeah.
Like a knee length white boots.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I see that. So yeah, this is the black version basically. So it's just preference really.
This will look nice. Somebody say I'm being racist. It will look nice on a white person.
For that.
Yeah. Because there's no anything.
Yeah. Each to their own. Okay. I think that's it for the festive sort of dresses. We might have more.
No, there's still more.
There's more dresses.
Yeah, you have two bags.
Yeah. So the next dress, this kind of is similar to the.
Yeah, similar, but I think this will be nicer on a black body because. Right. Do you get what I mean?
I've seen dresses like this actually. Uh-huh. So the top is very straight, sort of even borderline shifty.
A bat wing. Is it bat wing?
Not bat wing. I was just, yeah, flouncy, and then you've got the stretch cuff. And then this neck, what, mock neck? What do you guys call this?
Is it a mock neck or a boat neck?
Boat neck.
Is it?
I think boat.
Let me see, I can't even see.
It's literally just a little bit high and straight. Like, I don't know.
Maybe it's a high neck.
And then at the bottom is where the fun stuff happens. You've got this sort of ruched skirt, but the ruching is happening all over the place. So yeah, I mean, the dress speaks for itself, basically. I think this is, I like this one, actually. I think it looks really, really good.
This with minimal sandals will be very perfect. Nice. Yeah.
This is also in an extra small. Mummy has a lot of faith, but I think they don't.
Ishan, do you know what? I think maybe those were the sizes available. Extra small, is it?
Yeah. But it doesn't look like an extra small. I feel like I could fit this.
Yeah, because a lot of people say that H&M sizing is very generous. It's generous. So when you check the reviews, most of the time you see that they have a very, very huge, like, you know, that line. So that's why I wanted to try.
So yeah, I can't wait to try this one on. Yeah, some of them may be keepers depending on how they sit, but.
If this was a medium or a small, I'll take keep it, but I don't think
extra small is how you want. We'll see. And in
if you are well endowed, selling things,
this is gonna be interesting. I'm not a sequins fan, so we'll see what this looks like. But this is also in like a purple sort of color, and it's literally like a shift dress, right? Or street dress.
It's like a bat wing, isn't it?
Which I appreciate because the sequins are already screaming, so it's like. They've tried to keep it somewhat similar. That wing, like the simple, sorry.
This one I'd want to pair with white minimal shoes.
And this is actually a small, which is.
It's huge, isn't it?
Yeah,
it's big. Can even fit a large person.
Yeah. And the back has a little bit of an open back, not too much like the other one, but just a little bit sassy.
But out of all the dresses, this is my favorite. Yeah.
Okay, interesting. I think, especially, yeah.
I think for me, classy is always my go-to because this can be in your wardrobe forever and ever.
And it will always have its purpose.
But the previous ones with the ruching and all
very specific. That's what I was going to say. The mature woman, this one is actually really, really good.
Yeah, it is good for a matured woman, but if a younger body also wears this.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
It's like, oh, you look like, you're not like an average
girl.
Yeah, you look nice.
So yeah, this is size small. And yeah, hopefully you guys will also see this and try on. And if you like, you can pick up.
Is that it?
I think that's it for the festive dresses.
I think we'll end the video here. Yeah. Cause like we say, we want to make our videos very short.
Short and snappy. But hopefully you guys like the pieces and there's some things you would pick up. Like we said, a lot more Christmas stuff coming out, winter stuff,
jumpers and all that.
All of that stuff. So
we have a lot coming. We're trying to do the Cyber Week thing, but it didn't work. We're trying to put about 3 videos out in a week.
Oh, right. But
it's not easy.
It's not as easy as it looks at all.
Some of these YouTubers do it every day.
Yeah.
I was like, I read them.
YouTube. But yes, you guys are gonna see a lot more for us so that your Christmas week is sorted. You guys will have outfit ideas for any events that you have for Christmas. And yeah, hopefully we'll see you in the next one if it fits.
Feel free and have fun styling it.
Bye guys.
Bye.